Hey, my name's David Bowden with Spoken Gospel here in Oklahoma City. In 1 Thessalonians 5:17, we have one of the shortest verses in the whole Bible. Pray without ceasing. But this command to pray continually is only part of a sentence. In fact, it's part of a whole list. And this list also contains commands to rejoice always and give thanks in everything. You see, Paul is describing the daily heart posture of a Christian. God wants our hearts to be so dependent on Him, so bent toward Him, and so focused on Him that every moment of our day carries with it a disposition of joy and need and gratitude. But why is Paul talking about this daily heart posture he wants for Christians? Well, it's because he has been talking about Jesus' second coming and how it affects our everyday life. You see, the return of Jesus is a huge topic in this letter. Jesus will return suddenly, like a thief in the night. But Paul says that this day should not surprise us because we have fixed our minds on the truth that Jesus is coming back for us. And it is that expectation, that joy and longing that fills our hearts each day while we wait for Jesus' return. It's that longing that gives us this heart posture that Paul describes. We will continually rejoice and pray and give thanks when our hearts are filled with expectancy for Jesus' return. The opposite can also be said. Why don't we have as much joy as we could? Why don't we go to God in prayer regularly? Why don't we give thanks in everything? Well, it's because we have our minds too fixed on this world and what it can give us. We have our hearts too set on things below. But as we eagerly anticipate the return of Jesus, how he will make his dwelling with us, raise us to life, and make all things new, the more we will learn to do what God asks us to do here, to pray without ceasing.